Okay, I worked really hard before to get this video out, and I did my hair all cute, the makeup all cute, and all of that, and the sound fucked up. So I have to re-record the entire thing. So you guys are gonna get Megan with bedhead, and you're just gonna have to deal with it, because I don't care right now. Before I begin a breakdown of this book, I would like to issue a content warning. If you find depictions of cannibalism, incest, or rape disturbing, you should go ahead and skip this video, because there's lots of it. You're not missing much, I promise. Also, please don't watch if you're related to me in any way, because I won't be able to look you in the eyes. Sick Bastards is a book about a family in a post-apocalyptic world that finds themselves doing unspeakable things in the name of survival. Our story follows father, mother, sister, and brother. They don't call each other by name because they don't remember their real names. They just woke up one day with just no recollection of who they were. They figure they must be a family because they find what appears to be a family photo with all of them in it. So they decide on calling each other father, mother, sister, brother. Father figures that they must have been in a nuclear attack, and they are probably the only survivors. So our book begins with brother enjoying the company of a woman, and just as he is about to finish up, just as he's finishing up, mother opens the door and tells brother and sister to get ready for dinner. Yeah, that's what kind of book this is. So, right off the bat, sister's angry because she didn't get to have an orgasm, and she tells brother that he owes her one later. By the way, no, they are not underage. Brother looks to be about in his early to mid-20s, and sister appears to be at least 18, so the author covered his bases there. So brother and sister meet the parents in the dining room, where the meat was already strapped to the table and struggling to escape. Brother refers to the person as meat because it helps him mentally prepare to consume human flesh. Father wastes no time driving a knife straight into the man's leg, and he begins to cut off pieces of flesh for his family. When they first started eating people, they would try and kill them first, make it as quick and painless as possible, and then eat them just out of necessity. But it seems like these days, Father is enjoying torturing and killing people. Brother seems to be the only one at least feeling a little bit guilty about what they're doing. He's tried since the very beginning, since they ran out of food, to try and convince Father that the best course of action would be to leave the house. So they still see airplanes overhead, so there has to be more people out there, or at least another house for them to try and find more food rations. Father does not listen to him. He believes that if there are any other people out there, all they will do is murder them and loot their bodies. For what? I don't know, because they don't have any food in the house. So, you know. Oh, and there's also, they still have running water, which is strange. So in Father's eyes, any other person is either a looter or one of the creatures. So when they first ran out of food, Father and brother tried to go hunting in the forest for some animals, and what did they come across? It was a pack of zombies. That's right, this is a zombie story. I guess we all should have known when we saw the word post-apocalyptic in the description. And can I just say, I don't know why the family of the current time period, is so afraid of the zombies. I mean, yeah, a little fear to keep yourself alive is healthy, but they are so terrified, and the scariest thing about zombies is that they eat people, which, you know, the families know better in this instance. Anyway, back in present day, brother and sister go back up to their room where sister forces brother to have sex with her. Brother tries to tell her no, but she refuses to listen and proceeds to rape him. This scene was super uncomfortable for me, but still nowhere near as bad as the scene, as the flashback scene where the mother molests brother. That scene almost had me tapping out of the book. I almost couldn't finish it. So the next day, brother gets it in his head that he needs to leave the house on his own once again. He's tried it before, and he actually ran into another person. This was the first, like, non-zombie human that brother had ever seen. So he takes this guy and he brings him back to the house to prove to father, like, look, there are other survivors out there. They can help us. Father meets him on the front porch and goes absolutely ballistic and, like, really lays it into him, like, this guy is probably a looter. He's probably dangerous. Why would you lead him all the way back to our house? And brother just sort of snaps and just lops off the dude's head in one swing of an axe. It was pretty funny to me because it reminded me of, like, a whiny teenager being told to go to his room. Like, fine, Dad. If you don't like my friends, I guess I'll decapitate them. And that was the first person they ever ate. So, back in present day once again, brother decides that he needs to leave the house and not come back. And he's in love with sister, so he tries to convince her to come with him. However, father overhears this entire conversation and basically tells brother, you know, you can go, but she's not going anywhere. She is staying here. And, you know, sister agreed with father because she didn't want to cross daddy. So brother sets out on his own to the forest. Quick suggestion to brother, eat your dad. Eat your dad. I mean, it already seems like you're banging your mom and your sister more often than he is, so they'll probably be on your side anyway and can probably help you overpower him. Or you could just, you know, stab him in his sleep. Just a thought. So brother sets out into the forest, and just as it's getting dark, he comes across another house. It looks empty, so he goes inside to try and forage for food, and all he finds are crumbs. So he goes upstairs to the bedroom, and he finds the corpses of an elderly couple holding each other in their bed. It seems like the man had cut the woman's throat and then slit his own wrists, preferring to die a quick death than to starve to death in this hellhole. They were the sad bastards. Brother stays the night in this house and thinks about how jealous he is that father is probably having relations with sister now that he's gone. And he's not repulsed by this, he's jealous. And so this leads him to believe that he's in love with sister. So he decides he has to go back for her. But as he's making his way through the forest the next day, he runs into a pack of zombies and they spot him. And these are like the 28 days later zombies, so Brother has to run as fast as he can to get away from them. Finally, he comes across a large fence, a large fenced-in area that looks to be guarding a cluster of buildings. And Brother is so relieved that he found a group of survivors and they were going to help him out. He climbs a nearby tree to make it over the fence and he runs to the first building he sees. Inside, it was dark and I swear I remember there being a dead body, but that doesn't make any sense unless the zombies got into that area. So, and I'm not sure that they did. So, yeah, I can't remember. Anyway, doesn't matter. The important thing is that Brother finds a set of files with his face on one of them, and he finds files on all of his family members and the elderly couple, along with a bunch of others, but those are the ones that he recognizes. He notices that he and his family all have different last names. So he runs to the next building he sees and finds a man. I want to say he was in a lab coat, but I might just be picturing him in a lab coat, like, as a scientist, I don't know. Anyway, there's a scientist and he is standing in front of this huge wall of monitors. And he notices that they're recording and showing every little inch of, like, the forest, the outside of his home, the inside of his home, and a ton of other places along with it. The man begs Brother not to kill him and offers to explain everything to him instead. So it turns out they are all different people who answered an ad in the paper about participating in an experiment to try and earn some extra cash. The zombies were prisoners that they would inject with some sort of zombie-making concoction, and they would set them loose inside this fenced-off area containing the people who had volunteered for the experiment. I don't know what the point of the experiment was. I don't know, something science-y. I think it was maybe to see how normal people would react and what they would do against this type of threat, but I honestly can't remember, and I don't care enough to go back and try and find the answer. So, in a rage, Brother bashes the man's head in and decides he better go back and tell the other psychos what's happening. He makes his way back home through the forest, all the while thinking about what he's going to say to his fake family. He wondered how they could possibly acclimate to the real world after every single thing that they've done. You know, they've murdered people, they've eaten people, and they're just supposed to go back to society. Finally, he makes up his mind on what he's going to say to them as he reaches the house. So, father, mother, and sister meet him out on the porch. Brother looks at father and says, "Father, you were right. There's nothing out there. Can I please come back home with you guys?" So father lets him in, but you don't really know if it's because he's accepting him back into the family or if brother's going to be the next one strapped to the dining table. The end. I don't know. The book was just fine. It was fine. It was super uncomfortable in a lot of spots, but, you know, I know that was probably on purpose. And I liked that it wasn't trying to pretend to be anything that it wasn't. I found myself sympathetic to Brother in a Jaime Lannister sort of way. Like, I like him a lot better when he's not banging his sister. Of course, it turned out that none of them were related anyway, but he didn't know that when he was engaging in that activity. So this book is actually a trilogy. There's also Sicker Bastards and Sickest Bastards. So I will have to check those out and possibly do a breakdown on those as well. Next week, I'll hopefully post my January book list. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!